Now, vaccine hesitancy is a greatest barrier against containing COVID-19 because its mutation and the severe illnesses that it can cause is certainly causing angst amongst many communities. This is according to health professionals and heads at Investment Health, who painted a picture of what our future could be if we do not vaccinate. Joining me to sum up a conversation that was had by those health officials is Sinenhlanhla Nzama, head product actuary at Investec Life. Sinenhlanhla, thank you. Long intro I had to make, but it's important that we put things into context. You attended a summit or a webinar or a conference, let's call it what we will, that looked at these issues. And you guys have analyzed those numbers and you're coming to certain conclusions, one of which is that we need to vaccinate or we could see these things mutate every single flu season or at least throughout the year.
Yes, Godfrey, I think what we've been seeing unfolding with COVID and the various variants is that the risks of more variants coming into the fourth or more infections coming through are much higher when we've got low vaccination rates in a certain population, be it South Africa or anywhere in the world. So the more or the higher the population or the vaccination rates, the lower those risks of the transmissions and the lower the risk of having new variants. So I think most people will know now we're sitting, especially in South Africa and most of the countries in the world are sitting with the Delta variant that we've been dealing with. But the risk is that these are keep changing. These variants are keep changing and they're causing greater and greater risk than what you've seen so far.
So you guys have arrived what you are calling the Omega scenario. Explain it to the uneducated, including me.
Well, the World Health Organization has actually came up with a very simple system. They used the Greek alphabet to identify all the variants of interest or the variants of concern. So currently, the likes of beta, which was which is the second alphabet. So it started with alpha, which was the original variant. And then beta, which was first discovered here in South Africa, and it was a concern for everyone globally, and it's no longer now an issue. But then there was a Delta variant, which was first discovered in India. So these variants are then identified using the Greek alphabet. We're currently sitting in terms of the variant of interest with the mu, which is kind of halfway through the alphabet, all the way to Omega, it will be the last one. Just the concern, I think, with from experts out there in the market is that the more we move down the alphabet, the higher the chances that some people will call it a doomsday type of variant, which is much more aggressive or much more transmittable, which means it transmits much faster. And I think it's true that we've seen, for example, the current or the variant we've just came out of in South Africa, which is the Delta, it was much more transmittable than the previous ones. So the chances are you are risking as a global population, the more we move down the alphabet and the Greek alphabet, that it becomes more transmittable and much more deadly to the at-risk population, like the elderly or those people with pre-existing conditions.
Yeah, and that's the irony, isn't it? Because I saw from your write-up that it is the over 60s who are also resistant to getting vaccinated. Spell out the dangers from what you have seen and the conversation that was had around the risks associated with not vaccinating.
Yes, compared to the previous, I think, especially in South Africa, we've got a lot of experience in dealing with epidemics and the likes. But what we've dealt with, for example, is HIV, which we've got a lot of experience in. But it was actually a much more prominent and much more deadly in the younger generations or the younger population within South Africa. But what we're seeing with COVID, regardless of the variants, we've seen that it's actually much more lethal or deadly to people who are older and people who present some pre-existing conditions like diabetes, hypertension. So or people who generally will have compromised immune system because we've seen that the virus is attacking the immune defense systems, which is why then if you get vaccinated, it boosts that immune system defense system, that immune defense system. So people over the age of 60, data is just showing the death rates in South Africa and elsewhere in the world that it is predominantly largely people over the age of 60, but also younger people if do have pre-existing condition, including higher BMI as an example, does pose a greater risk regardless of the age.